Hello!
Ranos here, and welcome back to the first tree. Now, this game only saves when you go from one area to another, so everything we've already done this area hasn't been saved. And I can't remember where I've been. So... a Stiggy. Oopsie. What was the interact button again? There we go.
My dad built a lot of stuff in his free time. If he wasn't watching fly fishing or reading Tom Clancy novels, he was carving something. He made tons of birdhouses. Not that he was into bird watching, but I think he really missed working and adding on to the home.
Huh.
If he couldn't afford the time to build onto our own house, he would have to settle with watching birds move into their little homes. We kept an old mattress in the bed of that ugly yellow truck, so we would drive it deep into the woods and then watch the birds fly into their houses while the sun set. Usually it was accompanied by venison jerky or a cold Coke, but not a lot of talking, which is how we both liked it.
Okay, we've already gotten that one. There we go. Got these last time. Just need to find that house. That's where we ended off on last time. Okay. Oh my. This is huge. Ooh, there's more shiny stuff. There's still that obsidian rock I want to find again. There's three of them in this place. I'm going to activate all of them before we move on to the next zone. So let's see if we can find them. Well, once we get to these ones, we'll be able to get somewhere. Yeah, I'll be right back as soon as I find another marker or something. Well, I found one. All the way up here. A few shinies too. Funk. And dig up.
We were happiest underneath the evergreens.
Huh.
We decided it was time to finally map out the hundreds of acres we lived on, just to pass the time during the summer. He was only free in the evenings, so I would spend the day wasting time on dial-up internet and sketching, and then we would rush into the woods, pen and map in hand, before evening fell. Sometimes, the aurora borealis would cast a cold green glow on the mountainside.
Hmm.
We would finish our route underneath a twilight sky. Sometimes, I was lonely during those summer days, but there was comfort in the routine.
A lot of teenagers aren't looking for the daily grind, though. There's nothing wrong with wanting to get out, to leave your childhood home. You wanted to progress, to make something of yourself.
Fence.
Yeah, you're right. That house. I'm sure it's the same as how I left it.
Whoa, what the hell?
It feels so different.
I doubt you're the only adult to have looked back and asked that question.
So, now let's move on and find another location. Still need to figure out where those rocks were. Neat. In that area over there doesn't have any grass. Until I get near it. Huh. Doesn't seem like there's anything else around here. Luckily the glowy things do show up. Oh, hello. What do we have here? Computer! Yeah. Anyway. Oh, did I just see something? No. Well, let's get going. Let's see if we can find anything else. Because I saw some pathways I could go, like over there in the mountains, but none of them have the house. So I'm going to find all these places I found last time. So, let's continue until we find something. So, be right back soon as I do. I found the mattress I was talking about. A few cans around here too. But still no obsidian rock. Some stuff over here though. Shinies! As soon as I get there. I think I know why I can't find a house. I haven't quite got down to the right area yet. But oh well, let's just get up here first. And there we go. I just snap these. Then head up to that one. By jumping over here. Okay then. That's kind of weird. And nothing over there. And oh, there's one of the rocks. Not the one I found last time, but still one of them. Well, that's the thing. We haven't found the one where he talks about the rocks. So if we can find one of the main shiny things. There we go. Yay, got one of them. Anything else down below? Ooh, hello. To you. Nothing I can actually collect or anything. It's just... ooh, can't jump off. It's a long way down. How do we get down from here? That is... I'm not sure you can actually die in this game. Don't really want to find out. Whee! Yeah, I've fallen from great heights before. Whee! Now let's see if we can find that thing. That I saw. I thought that was another big shiny. Just the sun. Yeah. You know, I'll be right back as soon as I arrive at that thing. And here we go. There's a tent. A rather flat tent. Seriously. How do you even get in this thing? Well, there's a door, but it's so flat, you can't even crawl in this thing. I just quite help when they got a foxy jumping on it. Okay, I think I might know where I need to go to get the other obsidian rock that we found last time. So I'm just going to head that way. And I'll be right back as soon as I get there or find something else. Found something. Didn't take long. Oh, it's the house! So yay, we're close by. This probably isn't where the obsidian rock is, though. Doesn't look like the same area. Huh. And... boop.
On our property, there were old abandoned pieces of a shed and car long left unused.
That wasn't here last time.
I used to ask him all the time who those people were that left all this junk. I'm sure he got so tired of hearing it that he made up some elaborate stories how a brown bear ate them and haunted the woods afterwards. What's funny is I think it made those people seem more real. Growing up thinking they were still hanging out like they couldn't say goodbye. I used to tell my friends how I could swear I saw spirits move near the water, and that always freaked them out. I guess it didn't bother me, because the way I saw it, they were normal people with old cars and sheds, just trying to figure out how to survive and be happy in the middle of nowhere. It was a cool thought that they didn't want to leave, but you know, I was a weird kid.
Well, you had good company. Hey, since those ghosts like living in a place where you were brutally devoured.
Ooh, I remember that thing. It was kind of a pain in the ass to get, those little shiny things. Well, I figured out there is only 150 of those things to find. So I've actually kind of missed some. Which means I can't get all of them. Oh well. Pretty sure I can just play again. Now that I know how the mechanics actually work. You gotta press it quickly to get the most momentum. Not do what you can do in other games and wait for greater momentum and distance. Wait, there's a shiny thing over there. Huh. Don't think I noticed that one before. I think I'm going to the other obsidian rock, though. Come on, let's get there. Shiny. This is a single one all on its own. Strange. Yeah, there's the mattress over there. Ooh, there it is. Wondering where that was. So let's... Oops. Apparently can't run through that one. Yeah, then again, they do have quite thick branches and stuff, so... Probably put this model behind them. Diggy dig. Mine.
Even at my most distant, at the times when I detested him the most, he kept reaching out. For a year straight, he asked me every week when we were going camping. I thought he was just dense. Eventually, to shut him up, I agreed. We carried out the worn lawn chairs from the garage and set up a cinder block campfire at the site we'd always used behind the house. We walked down the mountain path, talking in the warm sunshine we only got a couple months of the year. Those three obsidian rocks shimmered alongside the shore, almost like sparklers pressed against a dark window. I'll never forget that wet stone on my feet, or how those massive mountains looked even bigger in the lake's reflection. I felt small, but grateful. As the sun set, my dad found something I hadn't seen for a long time. The tree where I'd made my first carving when I was 6. I hadn't even carved it. My dad had helped me, but I still called it my tree. Something about seeing my name there made me open up, and we talked about everything that night in that old camouflage tent. I told him how much I loved sketching and design, and how it would be a dream to study architecture in Seattle. I told him how I didn't get along with my friends much anymore, but that I didn't mind being alone. He told me he was there for me, and he joked that if all he had to do was write my name on a tree to finally get me to talk, he would have left me carved logs with novels on them in front of my room every morning. I don't know why it took me that long to realize it, but it was then I knew how much he had sacrificed for me.
Well, I'm just gonna keep hopping along here and see what we can find. I wonder if we find the Easter Bunny. Yeah, I found a big bunny. I mentioned this last time. I'm just curious at where it is. Is there anything around here? Well, hello. Can you go around this way? Oh, more shiny! Anything on this one? Don't look like it. Anything down here? Nope. Nah, nothing here. Whee! Oh, hello. Hey, little one. They're all hiding in the little creeks. All the little cracks. Oh, hell. There's more places to go. I'm probably going to get myself lost. Oh, hello. You see more of them. Probably getting myself lost in here. I'm not careful. Oh, there's more shinies down there. And now head down. Oh, you see the obsidian rock. Maybe there's a good reason for going down here. Yay! I believe those trees that are in front of the other obsidian rock are broke, allowing me to pass through now. There's nothing else here. So let's head off this way. Man. Whee! Well, mate, I want to fall down that way. I'll go this way. What if I find more shiny stuff on the way out? There is an achievement about talking about finding 5 secret hidden items. I believe there's one in each zone, and I've already missed 2 of them. Meh, that's annoying. I'd just be annoying if I missed them. Oh well. Let's head up here and see if we see anything. Well, that's interesting. Oopsie, a bell. Something over there. I need to get higher in order to reach it. How do I get up there? I believe this is the route to getting there. Or not, that's not steeper than I thought it was. No! God damn it. How do you get up there? Oh, I think I know a way. It's just gonna require a lot of jumping. On top of all these rocks. I'll be right back as I get up. Yeah, that plume of leaves is actually coming from the obsidian rock itself. So, yeah, there's not really anything to find. Oh well. Now I do wonder where these secret items are. Hi. In here? Nope. Well, I guess all we're gonna do is continue. Go, go, go! Well, we're here. And there's a shiny up there. Now, how do I get to you? Oh, there's a shiny on both sides! Now, how do we get to these shinies? Hey, there's a bear over there? Oh gee, that bear's not gonna hurt me, is it? Oh, there's a shiny down there too. Ah! Keep falling. Ah, no, 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 no. Oh, bugger. That works. Probably not what the developers intended, but never mind. Oh my. That one I won't be able to do like I did that the other one. Why can't I move? Nope, okay, I got stuck. Foxy, stop being stuck. Ah! Whee!
Nothing was wrong.
My dad is dead.
And he's never coming back, Rachel. I can tell you these stories, but I can never reminisce with him again. He can never hold a grandchild that we'll probably never be able to have. I can never talk to him again, and I'll never be able to say I'm sorry for everything.
So, Wolfie. Get back here, Wolfie! Whoa! We're really meant to be collecting these things while falling. Oh my! I was not expecting this part of the level. No, bye! Missed that one. Yeah. There we go. Last one. Missed this one, probably won't be able to get it back. Oh, gotta go in there. Ooh, hello! There's a shiny. Oh god, there's a few shinies there. Lined up quite well. Where'd Wolfie go? Bugger disappeared quite quickly. Am I meant to be finding anything around here? Huh. So we keep running down to the valley. Or something. Ooh, pretty. Yeah, it's just running down a hill now. Yep, just running. Wait, there's a shiny, there's a big shiny thing over there. Huh. Closer. Oh my. That's big rocks. The pathway that just keeps going. Lamy's area is big. Go find out what this is. And diggity.
I need to go to bed. We just can't talk about this anymore. Good night.
My. Wait, is that it? Probably more down that path there, but I want to see what's up here. For a second there, I thought I saw the wolf, but it wasn't, it was just a tree. Anything up here? Ooh. Bet I can get up there. From here, where the game developers don't want us to go yet. Or maybe they do. Sorry, they made it easy to do so. It took me a while to get up that, so be right back as soon as I am. Never mind. There's an invisible wall. Yep, invisible wall. Fuckery hell. Oh well, never mind. Well, I guess we just gotta keep going. And find our third pup. Oh, Kit, that's what they're actually called. Hello? Well, this was certainly interesting.
Joseph, you can't go to sleep feeling like this. I'm sorry for everything, and I know you need space, but I'm here for you. You don't need to.
Well, land up there.
Joseph, have I ever told you what my mother was like?
It's a deer.
Was watching the birds in the morning before the school bus came. I thought that my mother was one of those birds, and it made me want to be free like her. My mom taught me how to fold origami cranes while she was in the hospital, so I told myself I would fold one every day until I could fly myself. I think we both have always loved animals, and for me that love started with a dog. Sometimes this Rottweiler would come up to our property line and wait at the fence for me, but only once in a while. I was sure to check every day immediately after school, and it usually ended in disappointment. I would even steal money from my passed-out dad just so I could buy these off-brand dog biscuits. Even when she did stop by, she never went beyond the fence. Why was she so scared? I think my dad was the opposite of your dad in almost every way. Except he was in the military as well. He coped with alcohol of every kind. The trailer started falling apart, he got angry, and I withdrew. More and more I became the weird, quiet kid who made lots of origami birds and carried dog biscuits around. I think we were pretty similar when it came to being the weird kids. And that same sincerity in college was one of the reasons I was so drawn to you. Life got worse and worse. And at one point, I really didn't think I could survive another day with my soul still intact. I had no real friends, let alone neighbors, since we lived in the middle of nowhere. I should have talked to my teacher, but I was scared what he would do if he found out. As I waited for the school bus one morning, I walked around until I found something in an abandoned shed. Something I can't put into words. I summoned courage I didn't know I had, and I broke into my dad's room and found the key to the shed where he had locked my bike. I'll never forget that feeling. The wind rushing by my ears as the sun rose over fields of wheat. I was flying for the first time. I biked as far as my legs could take me until I found a house that felt friendly, and that felt like home. Those strangers helped me in so many ways. And if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have found my foster family. And if it wasn't for my parents, I wouldn't have met you. You have strength, Joseph. And you're not as alone as you think.
It's all just so pointless. Just waiting for life to happen. It's like having the home I always wanted is cursed out of my reach. The thought of being a parent myself. How could I do that when I couldn't even be a good son? I'm sorry. I know what you're saying. I just don't know how things will work out. These quiet hours will turn into years. We'll wonder which roads passed us by.
Then we'll forge a new road together. Besides, I discovered for myself that one fateful morning where any hopeful road leads to. There may be thorns in this, but it always leads to the same thing.
And what's that?
Family.
I'm so glad that you're part of my family, Rachel.
And I'm glad you're part of mine.
Well, that was a lasted a while. Oh my. Neither of them had a good childhood. What's this thing? This is a tree. Nope. And a fridge? Okay then. Wonder if I can open it. Nope. Seems absolutely massive. Oh well. Oh, I wonder what's over there. And a washing machine? Yeah, all sorts of things appear in a random place in this game. Well, it is only a dream, after all. So all sorts of crazy stuff can happen. That's just a dead end. Oh, hello! Bunk. 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 It's a bunny! Bun bun. Foxy jumping into the snow. Cool. Not sure if that's deer or an elk. Another Foxy. Are those flowers? Yeah, they look like flowers. I wonder if we can find anything like this on the other side. Pretty cool. Well, the only thing to do is go take a look. I'll be right back as soon as I arrive, because it's going to be quite the journey. Well, I found something all the way over here. Wardrobe! And fireplace. I did go past something else, but I was going to see what's all the way at the end first. Oh, hello. What's here? What's the for a fireplace? I guess that's the only thing around here, then. Well, I'd head to the other location. She isn't actually that far from this location. Just up there. Still not finding anything. So, let's head up. I was not expecting this. Strange. Yeah, I first saw the place when I was near that rock over there, because there's two shinies near that. And from then there, I saw more shinies. So, let's head up and see what we got. Then we need to head down to where all the deer and stuff are. Oh! Just leaves me on top. Eh. I think there's an invisible wall around here. Yeah, there is. So, oh, can't do a dive bomb into the water from here. Eh, it's too far off. Oh well. Oh my. I'm fine. Hi. I wonder. Ah! Punch them with their backs. That'd be funny. Whee! Don't seem like there's anything to find around here. Oh, hi. Personal space would be needed there. Oh, well. Got all the young ones running around. And the adults are just lying about. Well, the only thing to do is go up there now. Oh, I got these shinies. Time to go up the valley or something, I don't know. Oh, the shinies are there too. Am I going back into the mountain? Again, the foxy is still trying to find the first tree. Just need to go up here to find those other ones, and then we'll just see what happens next. Taking a while. Seems like there's a whole other area to run around in once we get up there. Oh my, there's an awful lot of rocks to jump on. Oh my. No, it's got one hell of a jumping puzzle to do. Huh, maybe it's not really a puzzle. If it just gives us an obvious layout. There we go, there's another one. Come on. Nope, okay. And bunk. Got it. Ooh, there's more. Don't run past anything. No. I think I have anyway. Why is that mountain ominously in the distance there? Can I find anything in here? Oh my. Nope, well, I can find our invisible walls. So I guess we just have to head towards the mountain. Oh, there we go. And we'll end this one here for now. And I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.